guys, Colleen here, DIYer behind LimitThistle.com, and today I'm excited to show you how to make this sweet little rose gold foil wood sign. I love foil, I would put it on everything, I have put it on a lot of things, and one of the things that I've put it on is wood. I made this wood sign last year. I made it using a liquid adhesive, which at the time was one of the only ways that you could put foil onto wood surfaces like this. And so I cut out a stencil using my Cricut and I painted it on and I transferred the foil that way. But since I made this sign, ThermoWeb has come out with, it's called Hot Melt Adhesive, and you can cut it with your Cricut or your cutting machine and you can iron that on, and that's your adhesive for the foil transfer. So I thought I have to try this out. So today I'm sharing how I made this little sign using my hand lettering, cut out with a Cricut, and transferred with the rose gold foil. And I really love how it turned out. I've got lots of tips that I've kind of picked up from playing with it a little bit, some things that I might try differently next time to get a bit of a cleaner look instead of this rustic look here. And yeah, let's do it. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, I would so love if you did that below so you don't miss out on any more home decor or DIY videos. All right, so the first thing that you'll need to do is upload your design. I just did this on my iPad in the Cricut Design Space app. You upload your own design and insert it onto your canvas. Now, when you're uploading a design, it's gonna give you a bunch of options to clean it up. This is great for if it's a photo of some lettering that you've done, but because this is already a PNG file or a translucent file, there's no cleanup that needs to be done here. When you go to cut it out, I just used the setting for cardstock. This worked just fine. I didn't have any issues with it, but keep in mind that it will cut through the backing as well as the hot melt adhesive. So I kind of want to play around with it a little bit and see if I can get it to just cut through the front without breaking the backing. So I might try a vinyl setting next time, but I just wanted to make sure that it cut through really cleanly, and it did on the cardstock setting. So because it cut through the backing as well, when you go to remove it from the mat, you're going to have all your individual pieces that you need to place. So just keep that in mind if you have a design that has really particular placement. You're gonna wanna mess around and try and get it so it doesn't cut through the backing. So you can peel off each of your individual letters or pieces, line them up, and when they're all set to go, then go ahead and throw a piece of parchment paper, which comes in the hot melt adhesive package, over top of that, and use your iron or a heat press just to heat that up. I used my Cricut Easy Press, which is kind of a cross between a heat press and an iron. And I just left it on the setting that it goes to automatically when you turn it on. I figured that was a medium heat and I pressed down on that. But I found that because the surface was so uneven that it worked really well on those higher boards, but the boards underneath didn't get enough pressure to actually transfer the hot melt adhesive. So I did have to go in and use the edges to get in those little nooks to try and transfer that. You can see that I'm doing that here. And that worked pretty well. If you did want a really smooth finish, as I mentioned before, then if you had one smooth piece of wood, or if you made sure that your wood pieces were all level so that the iron could rest evenly across the whole design, you'd end up with a much cleaner cut and a much cleaner design in the end. Once it's transferred, you can go ahead and you can peel back your backing and reveal just the adhesive. I expected this to be a little bit tacky, but it's totally not. So go ahead and cut your piece of deco foil to size and throw it over top of your design. Then once you've laid your deco foil over top, make sure you have the shiny side up, the colored side facing you, and put your parchment back on and iron it again. Make sure to get in all those little nooks and crannies and you'll see that it transfers. And when you peel it back, you'll see that your lettering is now a beautiful foil. So you can see where the iron had a hard time getting onto those designs, that it is a little bit patchy. I actually like how kind of rustic or antique this looks, and I went and sanded down the really smooth parts just to make them match that. But if I was doing a smooth piece, I would iron it a little bit longer and smooth it out a little bit longer just to make sure it was perfect before I removed it. So this is 120 grit sandpaper, and I'm just adding some distress to the really perfectly shiny parts just to make it all look equally rustic. When that's done, you're good to hang it up or put it on your mantle or whatever you like. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you hit that thumbs up button and subscribe so you don't miss out on any more home decor or DIY videos. We'll see you next time.